It seems like every week there's a new patch in NBA 2K22, both on current and next gen, and we're hearing the same thing. Stability update, another stability update. And if we're being honest, that's actually the main complaint most people have been having. I've been hearing the wildest stories of glitches and bugs ruining people's experience playing the game. There's a lot to talk about in a brand new update that just hit. If y'all new to the channel, man, drop a like on the video, man, and let's get straight into it. 1.4 gigabyte patch drop for next gen 2K22, 33 gigabyte update drop for 2K22 on the current gen. If you just go to the NBA 2K22 website, man, it's current gen patch update 1.4, followed by 1.6 on the new gen, followed by 1.5 on the update next gen. And all of them are boasting the same thing, man. The first note that you see in all of these is a vague one, and it says, additional stability improvements in an ongoing effort to improve the user experience. The devs have made it clear that they have no intention on changing the gameplay any more than they have to. There's some badges that have been tweaked, and we'll talk about that in a moment, but for the most part, they want to keep the gameplay the same. People have been enjoying the actual gameplay experience. I'm hearing from a lot of people this is one of the most fun 2Ks they've played in a while. How correlated that is to the fact that last year was the most atrocious gaming experience we've ever witnessed? Who knows? Literally, it might just be that last year was so ass, we're just thankful for mid. Who knows? Detective Agent lives his life in secret. In this redacted, what looks like innocent video, he looks fine. But upon a closer look, you can see his laptop screen is broken and he doesn't know if he could afford a new one. Well, that's where the sponsor of this video comes in, Affirm. Affirm helps you split up the payments, so if you want to buy a gaming laptop, you don't have to spend all the money up front. You can split it up in payments over time. Look how easy it is. All right, let's say you want to buy this Razer Blade 14-inch laptop. And for good reason, it's the most powerful 14-inch gaming laptop with AMD's Ryzen 5900HX and up to NVIDIA GeForce RTX 380 graphics. To fit that into a laptop makes no sense off the rip. Purchase, boom. Add to cart, boom. You fill out your information, there's no ding on your credit score, and then boom, you have the entire purchase amount that you can spend right now, or you can decide to make the payment over the course of 12 months or 6 months. So if you wanna make a big purchase, like a gaming laptop, man, click that top link in the description. A huge thank you to Affirm for helping sponsor this video. What I think happens in the NBA 2K community we don't talk about enough is the fact that something will go wrong in like 3-2K straight, and then we just accept it as like, that's just the way it is. We just got so used to it, we won't even criticize it no more. Man, I'm catching blue screens going, this ain't the worst 2K though in terms of blue screens. 2K17, 2K18 have worse blue screens. I gotta like wait for a moment. Hey, Adrian, hold on, step back for a moment. What is happening right now where I have just accepted the fact that 5 blue screens in 5 hours of gaming is acceptable? In any other game, bro, that's like atrocious, but on 2K we're just like, that's not that bad. I mean, look at the previous years, like that's how we think about things though. So then it's no surprise that 2K is focusing a lot of their updates on their ability to just make the game more, like more. And it's exterior stuff that should have already been fixed is the reason why we can't enjoy the gameplay experience. People have hit me up saying like, they can't even boot up direct the W Pro-Am Park. That every time they boot those up, their game gets blue screen and I've heard of people saying their consoles was bricked over playing 2K22. People's players getting deleted, that's just a constant. That happens in every 2K. We won't even talk about that anymore. But if you guys have been playing 2K for a while, you know that just because 2K doesn't put something in the patch notes doesn't mean nothing is going on. And people have been getting a little skeptical that things have been changing behind the scenes and 2K is not being upfront about those changes. Somebody sent a tweet to Baluba saying, can you talk more about the Limitless Spotter badge on current gen? Like, what is the point of that badge? It do not be popping up. So NBA 2K Lab completed some tests where they found that the restrictions placed upon the Limitless Spotter badge and the Chef badge are so strict that there can be circumstances where you're shooting from right here, spotting up, and the Limitless Spotter badge does not pop up at all because you're not more than 30 feet away from the basket. And these are shots that in 2K history have almost always popped up for Limitless Range, for Deep Range Extender, or whatever they used to call the badge in the past. And even for the Chef badge, they're talking about all the requirements necessary for having this badge activate, and it's like, it's so specific that you can shoot from the three-point line moving or spotting up and neither pops up. And these have been badges historically that have been the best in the game, consistently. They've been the most useful. People have retired their build and made a completely new one just to get Hall of Fame on Limitless Range or Deep Range Extender. So to have them be this useless in 2K was like something that 2K was trying to fix. And they did! NBA 2K put out a post saying a minor badge balancing update will go live for current and new gen tomorrow morning, containing the following: slight reduction in the effectiveness of the mismatch expert and blinders, increased effectiveness of unpluckable, no patch download is required for this update. This last part is actually pretty interesting because it kind of helps feed the theory that 2K has been low-key changing things. There's no secret that you'll hop on one day and the game will just feel different. We don't exactly know why. Like, the game could just be more responsive or less responsive, but it doesn't feel the same way it felt yesterday when you play. It feels entirely different. So then you stop to think, like, what else has changed? So Chalk, a professional NBA 2K League player, he put out a tweet saying, "Blinders was buffed, not nerfed, 1000% a typo." And this is something I've actually heard from a decent amount of people where they feel like things have already been changed. And if 2K doesn't actually have to drop a patch, they can just change things without saying nothing, then what's the chances that they're gonna reveal to the world that something's been changed every single time? It's actually much easier to just do the change in secret and then nobody notices anything changed. That way there's 0% chance, well not zero, but there's a way less percent chance that people are gonna get frustrated about a change that they didn't even know happened. Mike Wang reiterates here that we're trying to be extra careful to keep all day one gameplay balance intact as best we can. So these are pretty conservative badge tweaks. Please keep the feedback coming. 2K, it's a shame that like there have been great games in 2K history, like 2K19 and what sounds like 2K21 on current and next gen is gonna qualify in that category as long as something doesn't go atrociously wrong. And it wasn't the gameplay that it up for these games. It was just other stuff. With 2K19, the issue was a horrible shot contest system and balancing issues because Stretch Bigs ran the game. And with 2K21, it seems like blue screens and lag and horrible servers and unresponsive gameplay seems like that's gonna be the thing. And every time I want to cut 2K slack, I have to think to myself, man, when I play any other game, is the experience this inconsistent? And the answer is almost always a resounding no. And so then I'm like, I can't cut 2K slack on stability issues. And this is like the sixth patch we've received between current and next gen. And it's been like a month since the game's launch. Think about that. It's been like six updates, a stability patch after stability patch. One more, man. Another fucking stability patch. And still the game is not stable. I'm telling you, there's gonna be a time where 2K just deems it like, damn, let's just move on to the next game. This is good enough. 2K is gonna reach that point where they're like, this is good enough. I'm telling y'all. 2K, I need you to know that the game as it is right now is not good enough. That even though a lot of the biggest issues, like the hangups with the story mode that prevented you from continuing, from deleted characters, most of the issues have been solved, yes. But those are also issues that we literally should not have even had to deal with because the game should have came out more polished than it did. And it's so easy for me to fall back and say 2K21 next gen was worse. The first month of 2K21 next gen, we were playing on like 5 frames per second. It wasn't gaming, dog. That shit was not gaming. That doesn't qualify as gaming. I refuse to call it that. So this is better by miles in comparison. We know that. The launch of 2K22 was also better than the launch of most NBA 2K titles, even though it wasn't a good launch. It's such a delicate balance of like trying to understand, but then also like, come on, dog. Like, we have standards. Like, this is not meeting the standards. So this clip right here popped on the NBA 2K Reddit, and it's a clip of this guy skateboarding, doing a little ollie, and then he jump pads. Look, guys, look, a trampoline in the 2K22 city. The fact that 2K even has anything outside the city like this, I thought he was just gonna drop underneath this anyway, besides the plane. Oh, there's a follow-up clip. Where is this? Is this the penthouse? Where is this? This is tough. Is this the penthouse? This might be like the balcony of the penthouse. And then he fell. Look at how he's falling, dog. Like, look, this is a game. This is a AAA title, by the way, that dropped this year. People always like at me when something goes wrong with their game, like I'm the solution to the fix, which is like, I kind of get it. I talk about those issues on this channel, so I feel like I understand why they would at me. So I get the luxury of just hearing about most people's NBA 2K related issues on my Twitter feed. And man, some of the shit that I hear on a daily basis is insane, yo. I want to hear in the comments down below what unique bugs and glitches y'all been experiencing. But if not, man, there's a video right here where I walk around the city, and if I see an ad, I have to buy it at IRL, all right? It costs me a lot, to be honest with you. I'll catch you guys in the next one. I'm out. Peace.